as a maker of things, I have a great interest in how things have been made. And whenever I see a piece of glass, especially an older piece of glass that's using some sort of technology, some kind of craft or skill that's no longer in use or that we don't know about, I'm always looking for these clues. So to me, to leave these clues has become really important. My basic design process now is find something that I need, make it, use it, find out what doesn't work, redesign it, make it, use it again, and then put it out for other people to use and get their feedback. I always like the feedback of the customers and friends, etc. Part of the idea for the workshop that I'm going to be doing the next few days came from starting to be really concerned or interested in the kind of mark that the punky would leave. In this case, it just happens to be a P. It's great, it's funny, it's Peter. But, you know, I don't really expect anybody to ever notice that. And that's not really what I want people to notice. But what I would, it's kind of like this childish dream of mine that someday this thing is unearthed and they can tell from the mark that it was made in my studio by the mark of the punky itself or something like that. Anyway. I guess I've become interested in giving more opportunities for people to think about glass as a material by putting a little stone in it or putting bubbles in it or using the stretching process to make things. I found myself increasingly interested in the most minute of details in my sculpture and as well more and more so now in the vessels that I make, because I feel like if there's a really extremely minute detail and then something even more minute, one can lead you to the next, which can lead you to an even more minute place, and it changes a person's sense of scale. It puts them into the work.